Good. Hoop set, I'm going to be real. I'm probably giving 80%. Let me see your hand. You're like, I'm giving 80%. Good. I see your hands. Good. Somebody say, I'm giving 90, E. I'm giving about 90%. Good. I know I got 10% left. Who's like, I'm giving 100%? Good. It's 20% left. Who's saying I'm giving 120%? Good. So here's what I want you to understand. If Dr. Martin Luther King would have given 70%, we probably just not be getting civil rights. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm just saying, like we probably be right there right now. Like in the last 10 years, we probably, you understand what I'm saying? He gave 120%. And as a result of him giving 120, many of us have the luxuries we have right now. All right, so that's number one. I just want you to look at the level that you're giving. And look, I'm not telling you to give more, but what I am telling you is, if we're going to save our kids, then we're going to have to give more. All right, is that clear? So we're going to have to give 120 and we're still going to be struggling. All right, good. All right, good. So good, we got that one down. All right, so the next one is, right, that what I want you to do for me as it relates to your work is I want you to understand the importance of self-development as it relates to your work. All right, this is what I don't want you to do. I don't only want you to grow in the areas where your boss wants you to grow. So this conference is phenomenal. And we thank the director, we thank the deputy, we thank everybody that's responsible for having this. This is phenomenal. But the question is, how many of these are you gonna do on your own? I'm asking you a question. Like, how many of these are you going to do? So if they do one a year, can you at least match their one? So if they give you one conference, can you give yourself a conference? No, I'm just asking. So I want to say this, and I say this in all humility. Y'all know, for most of you who know me, I'm a high school dropout. Right? I'm a high school dropout. I was fortunate to get my GED. Right? Because of people like you. There were people in my life like you who encouraged me at 16 and 17 year old to go back to school and get my GED. From my GED, I went and got my 4-year degree. When I started doing the real work, and let me look this name up when y'all get a chance. Like this is what changed my life. Yummy Sandifer. Yep, look it up, look him up. 11 year old Yummy Sandifer. His real name was Robert Sandifer. He was a gangster disciple, Chicago, Illinois, 11 years old. This was like 2004, right? This was like 1994, right? Guess what they did to little man because he was a part of the gang. He saw somebody do something they weren't supposed to do. So they took him in the backyard and they shot him execution style at 11 years old. That changed my life. At that point, I was like, yo, E, you got to get serious now. You at the Boys and Girls Club, you at the YMCA, but you barely know how to read and write. How you going to help a kid get to the next level when you barely know how to read and write? Go back to college and finish. Took me 12 years to get a 4-year degree. And after I got my 4-year degree, went to Michigan State and got my master's. After my master's, my PhD. Listen to me closely. I don't have none of my degrees hanging on the wall. I did not go to college to hang my degrees on the wall. And I'm not mad at the person that's doing that because you paid for it and you paid for it. So you got the right to put it wherever you want to put it. But I'm telling you, I went and got my PhD because I realized, how you going to say you want to be like Martin Luther King when he had a PhD? At 26, Martin Luther King had a degree. He had a PhD at 26. Malcolm probably had an honorary PhD. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? W.E.B. Du Bois, these guys had degree. God said, son, how you gonna go out in the community and help the community when you can't, when you on the same level they on? How can you help somebody when you on their level? I can't help you. Jay-Z said the most important thing. Jay-Z said, you can't help. The best thing you can do for somebody who broke is not to be broke. That's what Jay-Z said. Jay-Z said, the best way for me to help a person who's in poverty is for me not to be in poverty. Because if I'm in poverty, I can't help him. So I said, the best way to educate this generation is to get an education. So I'm challenging somebody, write it down right now. You're like, E, this is what I'm going to do for self-improvement. This is what I'm going to do. It may not be go back to school. I don't know what it is. Write it down. You're going to listen to an audio book once a month. I don't know. 12 audiobooks a year, I don't know. You're gonna go to a conference. Do you know that Harvard and Yale, that they have free courses that they put online? They have free courses, so you ain't gotta go to Harvard if you don't feel like paying for it. You just take the free courses, but do something. Iron sharpens iron. You can't sharpen these babies if you're not sharpened. You can't sharpen them if you dull. Iron sharpens iron. Wood don't sharpen wood. So number two, in the area of work, I want you to write down, what are you going to do to improve yourself? What are you reading? What are you studying? Who are you hanging around? Now, I'm going to be real with y'all. This is why this is so important. I'm the number one motivational speaker in the world. Listen to me very closely. I remember when I used to go to schools and I was an A number, and I remember I used to walk in and it'd take me about 5 minutes to shut them down. I shut them down though, but it took about 5 minutes to shut them down. When kids see you with LeBron James, when kids see CP3 come out with a shoe in your honor, when I walk in the room now, listen to me, the best thing about being a number one motivator, the best thing about being a celebrity with these babies is when I walk in the room, I don't gotta tell nobody, shut up, sit down, be quiet. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So being number one, the privilege of it is when you walk into a room, the kids are like, yo, he was on the Meek Mills album, that's E.T. I don't care that they know who I am, I'm geeked that they shut up and listen. And we come from a society where young people as well as old, we look each other up and down. Don't act like we don't. Grown folks as well as kids look at credentials. You walk in a place and you a high school dropout, people like, oh, okay, okay. Talk to me, like, help me to understand why I'm supposed. It's real. Grandma walk in the room. When my grandma used to walk in the room, this wasn't my biological father, but he raised me. He was 6'8". His brother was 6'6". When my grandma walked in the room, all her sisters, everybody showed mad respect. My grandma walked in the room. Everybody was like, hell, Shirley. Why? Because my grandma could cook her butt off. So she had mad respect on the whole block. I'm being real. Some of you respect yourself, but you're not taking care of yourself. And you go into these programs and these kids looking at you like, who are you? And why should I respect you? Now, I know you think you deep and got it going on, but they don't think you deep and got it going on. And you have to impress them. You got to have some street cred for them. So what's your street cred? It's the work that you do, and when you sharpen yourself and you become a better tutor. Look, I'm the only motivational speaker with a PhD. You don't need one to do what I do. You don't need a PhD to speak, but you do need a PhD to change the culture of your community. You do need to understand leadership. You do. You do need to understand politics and how it works. You do. So do I need it to talk about, to pump up a football team? Absolutely not. But to change the dynamics of a community, yes, I do. So I'm asking you the question, what are you going to do for you? See, because you want a lot from the job. And they did, hey, look, yoga, anybody was blessed by the yoga? Let me see your hand. The meditation, let me see your hand. You've been blessed by this conference. You were blessed. So the question is, you want your job to do certain things for you, but what are you going to do for you? Like, what's too much? I have to ask my son sometimes. He's millennial. I'm like, son, what's too much? Like, for real, because you ask, dad, can you? I'm like, what's, son, at what point do you get that for yourself? So my son mad at me right now. He's like, dad, you cut me off. I was like, what you mean I cut you off? You cut me off. Like, you used to bless me more. Now I'm working for you, and I got to do all this stuff to get money. I said, because you're about to get married. I don't want her to respect me, I want her to respect you. But she ain't gonna respect you if I'm paying for everything. At what point? What you want me to get her a ring? What you want me to do? You want me to buy her a ring? No, you laughing, but at what point do you not expect your job to do stuff that you should be doing for yourself? At what point should you be trying to develop yourself? Good, all right, so you got the work down, put that one down, and just understand, I'm not mad at you. I would hope that you would do better, whatever percentage you wrote down. But I must remind you that the richest people in the world spend the most money on personal development. Go do your homework. The richest people in the world spend money on coaches. Denzel Washington has a coach. That blew my mind. I didn't have a speaking coach at first. And then I read Denzel had a coach. Go look it up. I said, who coaching Denzel? This is unbelievable. It don't look like Zell need no help with what he's doing. But maybe that's why he's the best, because he's got a coach.
Yeah.
LeBron James, look it up so you don't think I'm lying. LeBron James spent $1.5 million on himself last year. And you want to know why he the best in the league? You won't spend $150 on a program, but your shoes is worth $300. Just saying, for real. You won't spend, they want $1,500, boo, your purse costs three. You got a $3,000 purse. That Louis ain't $400. the wallet ain't $400, but you won't spend money on personal development. And so I want to challenge you. I want to challenge you. All the rich people in the world, all the people we look up to, those individuals are putting money into personal development. I want to challenge you to put some money in yourself. Don't wait for your boss to do it all. I go to school if they pay for it. You'll pay for it. You'll value it more if you pay for it. Is that clear? All right, so I just want to make sure before we start that you understand that. Now, let's go to the next one. So the next one is there should be vertical and horizontal communication between all of you. There's so much power in this room. There's so much knowledge in this room. But do you know how you destroy a powerful entity by dividing them? Because you can't take their power away from them. We are so blessed as a people. You can't take the power away, but what you can do is divide. I mean, you look at it, boy, I tell you, y'all thought Richard Williams did something with Venus and Serena. We thought Venus number one, Serena number one. We thought that we saw something. We didn't see anything to 20 some years later where other fathers now raise their daughters to be Venus and Serena. Unbelievable. I'm like, well, Venus getting beat by herself. I'm looking at the little Coco. Coco looked just like Venus. She looked exactly like her. Osamu, the young lady, Haitian and Japanese, she beating Serena. They produced them. Look at the little Steven. Look at all the little girls that's playing now, that's making it, they winning, they going to the next level. They beating Venus and Serena. Why? First of all, the girl's 20 years old, but still, 20 years later, she's still making it to the finals 4 years in a row after having the baby. You can't take away what we have. But what you can do is you can divide us. And when we're divided, that's what Malcolm, I'll go back and study. Malcolm, it hit Malcolm like, whoa. Malcolm was like, whoa, I need to get with Martin Luther King. Like, we need to stop being divided and we need to come together. And as soon as they came together, it was only a couple weeks later, somebody was like, whoa, they coming together. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It's okay when we're talking about killing each other. It's okay when we're talking about disrespecting our women. It's okay. But when we start doing some positive rap, don't nobody want to produce that. Don't nobody want to push that out. But all the negative stuff, we want to push out. So do me a favor. Listen to me. We are stronger together than we are. And can I explain something to you out here in this game? It's enough for everybody. But trust me. You trying to hide your information. You don't need to hide that. You would do more together. All right, true story. I want to be transparent. So Josh is on the team. Jamal's on the team. And CJ pulls me to the side at the beginning of the year. We're doing our mastermind where we bring millionaires together and trying to help them to get to another level. And you got all these big dogs working together. And CJ pulled me to the side. And CJ said, look, Eric, I need to talk to you. I was like, what's going on? He said, listen to me very closely. I know who you are. I know where you come from. You're a great dude, but your biological father wasn't in your life. Your mother lied to you about who your father was. You have some trust issues. And I can tell, as the four of us have come together, I can tell you gotta, because people aren't talking, and I know you used to be talking to you. They doing some business stuff, and they ain't showed you no paperwork. They ain't showed you the money. I love it. She was like, come here, sit down, though. Brought us all together. He said, E, you know I love you. You know I ain't never done you wrong. I said, absolutely. So he said, you ain't got to worry about him, and you ain't got to worry about him. So one guy's doing a solar company for us, another guy real estate. And what C said to me was, listen to me, Eric, it's no question you're going to make millions and millions of dollars. But we can do more if we stick together than we can if we go apart.